Welcome back to the next episode of The Future of Trucking. And in today's episode, we're going to be doing a review of ACT Expo. So there were a few different themes that we saw consistently throughout the show that we wanted to showcase with you. So the first was around ACF, the new mandate that just came out of CARB that says that fleets now need to adopt ZEV credit generating vehicles. So they've got the option of BEV, the option of fuel cell, as well as our Hypertruck ERX. One of the really interesting things, the way ACF is written, is all three of those solutions, all of them qualify for 100% of the ZEV credits. So now fleets really have a full portfolio of options of what they can adopt in order to be able to achieve this new mandate that came out. The second was around power generation. I think the story that says it all is you look outside at ACT Expo, you got a bunch of BEV fuel cell trucks all lined up, our trucks as well. The BEV trucks were getting recharged off of a diesel generator sitting in the parking lot. And, you know, yeah, you might say, well, yeah, that's at an expo hall. They don't have the power, the infrastructure set up. But this is a story we've heard time and time again, where fleets are actually bringing diesel generators to their shipping terminals and using those to power their EVs. So I personally think this is a step completely in the wrong direction, right? You might as well just use a diesel truck if you're going to use a diesel generator to charge a BEV. The way BEV works is if you're going to use renewable sources like wind, hydro, solar, or cleaner sources of electricity to recharge these trucks, not the diesel generator sitting in the parking lot. This really gave us the opportunity to strongly showcase the new Carno technology that we unveiled at the show to utilize it in a stationary application. So the Carno is a linear heat generator. It sits there, produces electricity, can run on over 20 different fuels at a very high efficiency, very low emissions. But one of the other huge benefits is it's extremely quiet. It's actually about the same noise level, or actually a little quieter than a normal conversation between two people. So we see that as an amazing market opportunity for us, that we can actually deploy that Carno to power these EV chargers. The next is around the hydrogen timeline. So I think the quote that I heard out there was, it's not an if, it's a when around hydrogen. And I believe that as well. There's so much investment dollars and government incentives going towards hydrogen. It's picking up steam, but it's happening at a much longer timeline than initially anticipated. Yes, hubs and stations are in the works and going to be built out, but we're going to see trucks start to be deployed around the existing fueling infrastructure that's out there. And right now there's only three stations, all in California. And then as more stations are built out, then you'll see more and more trucks in those areas get deployed. But that's going to take a long time. These stations don't go in overnight. It takes years. And so we still have a long ways to go till a hydrogen-based future. And that's where, you know, our philosophy of let's start with renewable natural gas and evolve into hydrogen, we think is ever more true. And then the last theme we saw was that fleets are truly struggling with the range they're getting out of their BEV solutions. So OEMs are, you know, quoting you can get 100, 150, 200, maybe 250, some up to 500 miles of range out of their trucks. Fleets aren't experiencing or actually seeing in the real world what is quoted as how far the vehicle can go. And what this is causing is fleets are saying, well, I'll deploy a 150-mile range truck on a 120-mile route, and the truck's actually running out of battery charge before it even gets back to the depot. And so with that, fleets are now having to look at, you know, initially thinking, okay, this percentage of my fleet could work on BEVs. It's now actually a much smaller percentage, because very little bits of trucking actually go that small a range in a daily basis. And that's where having range extender type solutions are, you know, starting to be the shift to where fleets are looking at. So those were the four themes. ACF mandate, it's passed, it's coming, it's here. Power generation for EV chargers, big problem. Hydrogen timeline, it's longer than expected. And then the range BEVs are getting is falling short. With all that, there was so much excitement, so much new technology out at this ACT Expo, that this shift towards cleaner, greener solutions is happening, but we just need to be practical and logical about where we're going to deploy the right solutions. Thanks for watching.